Hello, in this video we're going to take a look at the volume region element that is new to Kubla Cubed 2019. The volume region element is for reporting additional cut and fill volumes in specific regions. The standard report can break down the cut and fill for an entire phase, and it can break down the cut and fill by element. Elements that intersect are reported as a single one, so in this case there'll be two sets of cut and fill in the element report, one for this cluster of earthworks and one for this building pad. The volume region tool allows you to report in even more detail by defining specific regions to report on. So to create a volume region, all you do is click on the plus sign in the measurements panel, select volume region, and draw over the area that you want to report. So in this case we might want to report this structure at the top here, and so we just draw a region around it like this. And we also might want to, say, report on this pond. So in addition to the element breakdown as before and all earthworks in phase, we're now going to have a breakdown by volume region. So it'll report this one, and the remainder here. So we'll just demonstrate that. If we go File, Create Spreadsheet, Earthworks Estimation. So here we have the earthworks by element. The main cluster of earthworks is reported as one because those elements intersect, and then we've got the pad one that's separate to the others. And now we have this earthworks by region, region one, region two, and remainder. And then we also have all earthworks elements in phase. So at a basic level, that's all there is to it. So there's a few points that need to be made before moving on from volume regions. The first is that you can't have intersecting volume regions. So the reason for that is because it would get confusing, and if you had areas of fill reported twice in the same list. So in this case, if we try and report a spreadsheet of the earthworks estimation, it will say that the export failed because we've got intersecting elements. So we just have to correct that. What you can do with point snapping is have adjacent elements snapped to each other. So make sure to boundary points is turned on, and then we can just drag these points and snap them with an adjacent region, so you can have regions butting up against each other nicely like that. Another thing to note is, even though you can't have intersecting regions, you can have a region within inside a region, and that's handled intelligently by report. So if we have a region here, what will happen is this region 4 will be reported, and then this outer region will be reported excluding this inner region's cut and fill volumes. So that means that we don't have that confusion of the same fill being reported twice, because this inner region will be reported but then the outer region will have that excluded from it. So lastly, measurements are specific to a single phase. So in the report, these regions will report on this bulk earthworks phase but not on the site strip. And if you want to have those regions reported throughout your phase, it's just a simple matter of copying and pasting them from one phase to another. So you can select these group and then just copy and paste into the site strip, and then you'll find in the export that the strip now has the same breakdown by region there. So that's the end of this tutorial. If you've got any questions, please post in the comments or on our forums. Thanks for watching.